Hi, this is Professor Kleitz. In section 7-10, I want to talk about arithmetic logic units. They're typically available as large-scale integrated circuits, LSIs, and also you'll find the term ALU, or arithmetic logic units, as part of a microprocessor. The core inside a microprocessor will have arithmetic operations capability as well as logic manipulation capability. But as far as having an ALU as an IC, let's take a look at the 74181, which is the ALU we're going to talk about in this section. This is the logic symbol for the 74181 ALU, and it has two 4-bit inputs, the A string and then the B string. It allows for a carry-in, which actually is an active low carry-in. It's got a mode control, which can either be high or low, and we'll look at the mode functions in a minute. And it's got a function select. Now, with four possible function selects, we can get 16 different possible functions out of this ALU. On the output side, we'll have the F outputs, which is a 4-bit output, which will be a result of the inputs that you provide. It'll have a carry out, which again is an active low, and it's going to have an equality output, A equals B. It's going to have a generate and a propagate output, and we'll look at these in just a minute. And figure 27B is the function table. And basically, there's the two columns we want to look at. The column for the logic operations when you make M equals a high, and the column when you have arithmetic operations is which when you make M equals a low. Basically, logic functions are going to be our invert, our NOR, our NAND, we've got exclusives, non-exclusives, all sorts of logic operations. And in the arithmetic column, we're going to be doing additions, subtractions, and so on in the arithmetic. Now, once you pick your mode, then you do the mode select on the S3 through S0. If you have a 0000 on these inputs, then you'll be using, if you're in the logic function area, F is going to be the complement of A. Now, when they say F equals the complement of A, what that means is F sub 0 is equal to the complement of A sub 0, F sub 1 is the complement of A sub 1, and so on. In the arithmetic operation, here I'm just saying F is equal to A, whatever A is. In other words, nothing is going to change on the output at F, and here I listed out F sub 0 equals A sub 0, F sub 1 equals A sub 1, and so on. Let's look at the next. So if we have all lows with a high on the S0, this is going to, in the logic function area, this is going to function as a NOR gate. And if it's in the arithmetic where you have M equals L, then it's going to be the sum of A plus B. And again, it's every single bit of the A string is added to every single bit of the B string, creating a 4-bit F answer. So as you can see, going down the columns, there's the basic operations, NANDs and NORs and ORs and so on, inverts. But then there's some real specialized ones where, like for example right here, F is going to be, you're going to complement the A string and OR it with the non-complemented B string. Some weird operations like that. And the same with the F arithmetic operations, you got your basic addition and subtraction, but then you have some other oddball ones. So the best way to learn how the 74181 works is to run an example. And so in example 723, we're going to show the external connections to the chip to form a 4-bit subtractor. We're going to label the input-output pins with the binary states that occur when subtracting. Let's do 13 minus 7. And here are the inputs and outputs. The bluish cyan color are the inputs we're going to apply, and the outputs are also listed out here on the right hand side. So on the A string, we're going to have the number 13, the 8-bit, the 4, and the 1, I got these backwards right there. There's the least significant bit up there, so that's the 1-bit, the 4-bit, and the 8-bit. And then here's the number 7, which is the 1, the 2, and the 4. And since we're doing a subtraction, we got to put the M in the 0 mode, which means we're going to be doing arithmetic. And then when you look at the function table, there's no such command as a minus b. The only thing we have access to is a minus b minus 1. So the fact that we're subtracting the a minus b and then we're subtracting another 1 from that, we're going to have to force a carry into this to make the answer come out right. Now this carry, when you put a 0 on here, that means you do have a carry in. And that's what we have to do to get rid of that a minus b, the minus 1 part of the a minus b. Okay, so here's all the S's, the mode control setup. We had to bring in the carry, and here's our 13 minus 7. Now the answer for 13 minus 7 is supposed to be 6, and we will see 6 on the output. Since this is 2's complement subtraction, we will see a carry out of the most significant bit, which we always ignore. And the other 3 we'll just ignore. So these are the connections for that subtraction. So let's try a couple more examples. In example 724, I'm telling you what you're going to place on the input. So here's the A3, A2, A1, A0 is going to have that number 9, 1001 on it, and the B's will have that string, and the S's will be set up like that. We'll put the CN equals 1, which means no carry, and then we'll try it with the mode equal to 1, and then try it with the mode equal to 0. Now with the mode equal to 1, what would you see out there at the F's? So why don't you take a minute and try this yourself before I go and explain how this works out. Okay, so I assume you've tried this on yourself. Here's basically what I came up with. From the chart that you see in figure 727B, the logic function that we chose is the output at F will be equal to A ORed with the not B, with the complement of B. So what we do is we write down the A string, we write down the B string that we input, but then we complement bit by bit, and then we OR this resultant, the complemented B string, OR that with the original A string. So we have an A OR with, or a 1 ORed with a 0, that's a 1. You take a 0 ORed with a 0, that's a 0. You take a 0 ORed with a 1, that's a 1. And finally, you take a 1 ORed with a 1, if that's a 1. So here is our answer. So that was using it as a logic device. Now, as an arithmetic device, you make the M equal to a 0. Now what would you see out at F? Well, when that's 0, the arithmetic operation is, from the table, it is A ORed with B. This is a logical OR. And then you take that result and you add to A. So first of all, you take the A, B, list them out, and you OR them. 1 ORed with 1 is a 1, 0 with a 1 is a 1, 0, 0 is a 0, and a 0 with a 0 is a 1. And then we take that result and we add A to it. So if you take the A, the first bit is a 1, and you add that to the A or B bit, which is this, 1 plus 1 is a 0 with a carry. 0 plus 1 with the carry is 0 with another carry. The carry comes around. Carry with 0, 0 is a 1, no carry. And then you come around, 1 plus a 1 is a 0 with a carry. So our answer on the F string is 0, 1, 0, 0. I hope that's what you got. So there'll be a couple more of these for you to try at the end of the chapter in the homeworks. And there's also 3 review questions in the textbook. So take a look at those review questions related to this, and then do the homeworks at the end of the chapter. So that completes section 7-10. Next, we'll take a look at using VHDL and LPMs to implement FPGA designs. That'll be section 7-11 coming up.